it's not too complicated to see where Satan is leading the world with his music when one realizes what the Word of God says in the book of Daniel. In the book of Daniel, we see that musicians were used as tools to get people to worship the image of Nebuchadnezzar, a picture of the Antichrist. Several New Age books have surfaced in recent history promoting the number of the Antichrist, 666. This book, which purports to be a guide to working with your spirit helpers, features a stylized 666 on the front cover. New Age books, however, are not the only tools that Satan is using to promote the number of the Antichrist. Just as Satan effectively used rock music to usher in the sexual, drug, and occult revolution, Satan is now using rock music as a brainwashing tool to promote the Antichrist. The band Rancid, who received extensive airplay on MTV, can be seen here with a satanic pentagram over the number of the beast, 666. Several other rock bands have incorporated the number of the beast into their very names, like Destroyer 666 and Mafia 666. Several rock artists wear the number of the beast on their shirts as they promote the coming Antichrist kingdom. Here we see a member of the group Entombed with a shirt advertising the number of the beast. Here we see Beelzebub, yet another group, wearing the number of the beast. And here we see a member of Rob Halford's group Fight, who headed up Judas Priest. This band member is also wearing a shirt promoting the number of the Antichrist. The popular satanic band that received an incredible amount of airplay by MTV, White Zombie, has also promoted the number of the Antichrist. Here we see the death metal band Venom with a satanic pentagram and the number of the beast. Venom sings in their song Possessed, quote, "I am possessed by all that is evil. The death of your God I demand, and I sit at Lord Satan's left hand." Satan is clearly using music to seduce the youth into damning their souls by programming them to take the number of the Antichrist. The group Acheron features a satanic pentagram and the number of the beast on their album Rites of the Black Mass, and they encourage their fans in one song to, quote, "Take the mark from Styx. The symbol is 666. The multi-platinum group Iron Maiden, like Acheron, encouraged their millions of fans to take the number of their beast in their song. Sadly, Black Sabbath also featured the number of the Antichrist on their album, Sabbath Bloody Sabbath. The band Love 666 makes it clear where they are coming from on their album Please Kill Yourself So I Can Rock. Here we see that Aphrodite's Child has also promoted the number of the beast, as has the rock group Satanic Surfers with their album Motor Inn 666. Danzig is yet another band from a long list of rock stars who are promoting the number of the Antichrist on their album Satan's Child. Marilyn Manson, who can boast of having millions of fans, is seen here wearing pants that are covered with sixes. Here we see that Paradox has also promoted the number of the beast on their album. We have already noted that Metallica has sung about selling their souls to Satan for power and fame. Here we see on their Black album a coiled serpent, which is an ancient depiction of Satan. When the serpent is mirrored, what we see is the number that keeps coming up again and again with rock music, 666. Rappers like Bones Thugs and Harmony and Eazy-E also utilize the three sixes. Eazy-E declares the following. You can tell that I'm sick by the triple sixes. I hear voices in my head for what reason. But when the talking stops, it's stopped by a season. So back, you can tell that I'm sick by the triple six, six, six. The satanic band Sepultura uses a stylized 666 similar to the book on working with your spirit guides that we looked at earlier. The circular 666 is also seen on the shoulders of Tommy Comerford of the incredibly successful rock band Rage Against the Machine. The band Slipknot can be seen here with a barrel with the number of the beast upon it and a satanic pentagram on the equipment case. Besides promoting the number of the beast, they also perform with barcodes emblazoned upon their backs. Here we see an advertisement with Paul Jennings, who invented the barcode. This is an advertisement with the barcode on his forehead. Here we see a picture of a Dead Kennedys album with the number of the beast, 666, emblazoned across the barcode. God's word declares that the Antichrist will enforce a one-world system of commerce where it will be impossible to buy or sell without the mark of the beast, which is either the name of the beast or the number of his name, upon one's right hand or forehead. It is interesting that the most popular form of the universal product code has lines that represent numbers. Each two lines represent one number. It is interesting that one of the two sets of lines representing a six is that of two thin lines seen here. Incredibly, the lines that they use as brackets at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end of the product code visually corresponds to the lines that represent the six. Thus, most of what we buy and sell already has a visual correspondence to the number of the beast, 666. While this, in and of itself, does not constitute taking the mark, name, or number of the beast, it does show where our world is headed. The Smashing Pumpkins, who were one of the most successful alternative bands of the 1990s, have also promoted the coming Antichrist. Here you see Billy Corgan promoting the number of the Antichrist on his shirt in concert. The Smashing Pumpkins have repeatedly blasphemed God throughout their lyrics, stating that God is empty and that God is zero, etc. Every game you play, every night you stay, I'll be watching. We have already noted that Sting, formerly of The Police, admitted that he is influenced by Satanist Aleister Crowley and that his song, Every Breath You Take, is not really a love song at all, but as he said, is absolute poison. It is about the coming Big Brother Orwellian system. On their album, Ghost in the Machine, they have a song called One World. God's word declares in Revelation chapter 13 that all nations, kindreds, and tongues will worship the beast by taking his number. The computer digits on the front cover of Police's album, Ghost in the Machine, do not seem to make a lot of sense until they are mirrored, and then it becomes clear that they most closely resemble 666, the number of the Antichrist. It is interesting that God's word is written in Hebrew and Greek, both languages' alphabets double as their numbers. Since letters are equivalent to specific numbers, we can understand how the number of the Antichrist name can numerically be equivalent to 666 in Hebrew or Greek. It is interesting that not only do the brackets for the UPC codes employ three sets of lines that are visually equivalent to the lines for a six, but the acronym for the World Wide Web, WWW, is equivalent to three sixes in the Hebrew alphabet. The English W is equivalent to the Hebrew Wah or Vav, which is the number six in Hebrew. Incredibly, the prefix for the World Wide Web address is three sixes, www, www equals vav, 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 or 666. While God's word does not state that we cannot use computers, it does warn that we are not to allow ourselves to be branded with the number of the beast on our right hands or our foreheads. It appears that this one world numbering system is right around the corner, and that Satan is using rock music to pave the way. God's word warns in the book of Revelation, in the severest of language, that all of those who take the mark of the beast will be punished forever and ever in eternal torment. Revelation chapter 14, verses 9 through 12 states, quote, "A third angel followed them and said in a loud voice, if anyone worships the beast and his image and receives his mark on the forehead or on the hand, he too will drink of the wine of God's fury, which has been poured full strength into the cup of his wrath. He will be tormented with burning sulfur in the presence of the holy angels and of the Lamb, and the smoke of their torment rises forever and ever. There is no rest, day or night, for those who worship the beast and his image, or for anyone who receives the mark of his name. This calls for patient endurance on the part of the saints who obey God's commandments and remain faithful to Jesus."